serverless architectures require, they're inherently and fundamentally different from traditional architectures, so that you can take advantage of the ability to manage services. So with AWS Lambda, it has to have a timeout on it so that the execution environment can get recycled so that AWS can update the OS and the runtime underneath. Mm-hmm. Whereas if you have an indefinitely running container, there's no point at which in that life cycle AWS can do the updates that they need or manage the things inside that container. And so I think it's important to keep those kind of constraints, those ephemeral compute, the kind of constraints that allow for highly managed services that take operations burden off us. And if we can do that, and if we can make sure that we're teaching new developers to think in that way, to think in how can I construct my system so that I can own as little technology as possible, so I can better accomplish my business goals, then we're gonna enable, we're gonna unlock cloud computing for a lot more people, because this hard technology problems get solved and provided as a service.
Yeah.
And so more people who don't need to worry about solving technology problems can come in and solve interesting and new business problems.